listening, Mike Cron told me years ago, you kind of need a sequence to, you know, first thing is sort of your setup, so your posture. I think that's a massive thing people don't kind of pay a lot of attention to. I think as long as you get that in the setup, you get, you know, you see the props or flat back, what type of thing. You bind them with the hooker, you're getting as comfortable in left position pre-engagement and knowing your body angles and knowing the sort of space between you and the loose head where you can kind of get into a position where you can dominate. And
Crouch.
So yeah, so you kind of, is there a call, you kind of, whatever, yes, or the hooker will call seconds and you kind of just get into that position.
You just crouch down and making sure your back's flat and in line with the front row, because you don't want to have you be higher than your hooker or your loose head, you want to be flat together and doing it at the same time.
It's a strange one, because the newish rules with the bind, you know, it's taking a wee bit of space away. I think when I started playing, I think the first World Cup in 2003 I played in, I think it was crouch, engage. So you kind of came, you could come, it was whoever got the kind of most momentum from that. But now it's obviously been brought back in, where you're basically looking to get your best finishing position when you're in the bind. So where you know where you're going to end up in your best sort of position you could be to sort of hold the scrum up, really. So you're just thinking about that. You know, set props these days, there's a lot of weight coming against you with this new bind, that, you know, especially New Zealand teams have put a lot of weight against you that way. So you kind of got to counteract that, really, whether you're putting weight back on them or being higher or lower. So. On the bind these days, you kind of, some props aren't that, you know, don't put much weight, but a lot of props want to put a lot of weight back on you, forcing your feet backwards, forcing a kind of ricochet effect.
You've got to realise how far away your loose head prop is from you. If he is close, then you're probably going to go pre-engaged, even though these days they try and avoid that, but, you know, as the game goes on, the referees just kind of want to get on with it, so you've got to win the 6 inches, we call it, and make sure your feet are underneath you.
The further you can get your feet forward, the weight over your feet into a shape, your whole eight can use that power then to go through it. Some refs will want a gap, and some, you know, you play certain refs where they allow you a space and they want that space, and they say, which is a hit.
If there's a hit, then you've got to brace and hold the weight and prepare for that set call.
Set!
At the moment, it's kind of just winning that kind of 6 inch sort of in the middle of the scrum. If you can get your pack as eight over that earlier, the earlier the better. You know, it's better for you. If you make the team readjust, that's even better again.
There's a lot of pressure, and you've got to be able to take it. And another big thing for me is making sure my feet are underneath me, and nice and parallel. My back's flat.
It all depends on how long the ref wants to wait till the ball comes in. You know, the better refs get in as quick as possible. You know, some refs take a while to get in, which makes the scrum a lot more unstable then anyway. So.